could have invited 1,000 people, they all would have been there. I guarantee it. He had 3 wonderful children, me. And then he had Cathy. And then he had Cathy. Well, you know, you're the oldest, so whatever. And then he had my brother Stephen, who passed away in 1995. And he is definitely here. Guaranteed that. He's munching on the sound, he's drinking wine, he's doing the whole thing. He's definitely here. A little bit about my dad. His first job was Coca-Cola. He loved Coca-Cola. If you ask him right now, probably wish he never left Coca-Cola. Stayed there 40 years, retired, grabbed about 10 grand a year in retirement, be happy ever after. But he did. From that, he moved over to the white food store that he opened up with Nani and Noni, my mother's mother and father, and they opened a grocery store. Where was it, Dad? Where? On Santa Clara Street, Oakland, right? Santa Clara. From there, he got wrangled in to go into the Buffalo Club with his father. Father opened that in 1920. When did Grandpa own Buffalo Club? When did he start?
1929.
Opened that. It's kind of weird. He opened a bar in Prohibition. Kind of weird. There's a lot of things about Grandpa we don't talk about, and that's going to be what. So we're just going to venture right out of that moment.
We're just going to
We're on it. Stayed here for 30 plus years with my Uncle Vince. My dad went to Frick Junior High School, then transferred over to Fremont High School. He played football back in the 40s or whatever. He's 6'2", 220 pounds. That was a monster back then. I played football for them, he wrestled for them, he played track for them. Just so happened somebody liked what he did. He got a full-blown scholarship to San Jose State for football and wrestling. 2-sport, which was pretty cool. He was president of the Block F Club. Cathy? And he was president of the High Y Club, which now would be called like the YMCA. And he was president of that. And I think that's about all I have for right now.
Well, if you look at your tables, all the tables are, you have an address or a school to label each one of the tables. So when I asked my dad, I said, hey Dad, you know, where have you lived? For your life. He named off every single address, not just the street, but the full number with the years that he lived there.
Nice.
Ricky too.
Maybe.
But he has always taught us respect. In our household, the one word that was mentioned over and over again was respect. You respect us as parents, you respect your family, you respect your friends, you respect people, whoever knows that comes into your life. And that has stayed with us all through our life. The other thing is that my dad, and Dad, I still can picture where I was when you told me this. But I was having a fight with somebody, and I was mad, and I wanted to, I just wanted to do, you know, But what my dad taught me, or said to me, was, Cathy, you always do the right thing. It doesn't matter what other people are doing out there. You do what's right, and that will always come back to you. And I've always remembered that and tried really hard to live my life like that. So thank you, Dad, for that wonderful thing.
Yes.
Dad, I love you dearly. I'm so proud to call you my father. And if you, some of you here, and not people that aren't even here, they consider my dad their dad. They really do. They really think of him as a father figure. And the one thing about Rick and I and my brother Steve is we always were so proud to share him with anybody that needed that father figure around. So if you please raise your glass. And Dad?
Yeah, cheers.
Cheers. Happy 90th birthday.